It's like nothing I've ever seen before.
I was a reporter in Hartford, Connecticut, and I spent days in a live truck because there was so much snow, there was so much bad weather, we were stuck out there covering it for Channel 3 in Hartford, I think it was. And I believe I got to know some folks really well.
The fact that our building had to be evacuated because the windows were blowing out from the extremely high winds that we were having, and getting down onto the street level and wondering if another window was going to blow out and bust on top of my head. So it was a little bit scary at that point.
I was working in New York City at the time, and I just remember that day, people on Third Avenue actually using snowshoes and skis going to Central Park.
There was also a tremendous amount of shoreline damage, and a lot of homes were actually washed away in New Jersey, New York City area, and also out of Long Island.
We were trying to get to the hospital to my wife to have this baby when this nor'easter hit. And it was an ice storm. Everything froze. It was really wet, and then all of a sudden the temperatures plummeted, and everything was frozen solid. And I remember my mom and dad came to visit me from Georgia. They lived in the south. So none of us had ever seen anything like this before.
The wind was just howling.
And literally, to get out of our driveway, we had to borrow my neighbor's pickaxe to chop through the ice. You couldn't shovel it. It was just, everything was frozen solid. It was an ice storm. After the rain, the temperatures plummeted and everything just froze.
It was unbelievable. I mean, I remember, first of all, we were trying to shoot the weather, and my photographer was out there trying to, you know, capture pictures of this. His hands were literally, frostbite. He couldn't get his fingers around the camera. It was unbelievable. We had to beg some emergency workers out there trying to get the power lines up for some gloves. And they gave him some gloves. Within, you know, minutes, those were sopping wet and freezing.
The East River Drive flooded when the ocean surged upwards through the East River, and the East River happened to come over onto the East River Drive. And I remember seeing photos of cabs and cars being rescues taking place in cabs and cars because of all the flooding that had occurred.
People banded together, I think, for the first few days, but then when power was out for quite a long time, it started to become concerning. I mean, there were elderly people who were in their homes for long periods of time who, you know, people couldn't get to them, and you really started getting worried for your friends and your neighbors.
People were handling it quite well, but there were a lot of problems, especially with the tremendous coastal flooding that occurred.
At first it was, you know, everyone sort of rallied together and thought they'd just sort of fight through it, but it became a pretty big storm, huge weather story.
They called it at the time the storm of the century. That was a term that really got our attention. Great, we just moved to the East Coast from California, and we're just in time for it, the storm of the century.